don't try to assume that you know what people are thinking and doing, and don't assume that.
Hi, welcome to the Black Experience Japan's Melanated Files. The purpose of this series is to highlight the black people living in Japan. Who are they?
My name is Robert. I am from Canada, but I was born in Jamaica. I'm from Toronto, or Ajax. I usually say Toronto because no one outside of Canada knows where Ajax is. What drew me to Japan is I want to do the big three. So I've already been to Korea, I've already been to China, now I was curious about Japan. I am a ESL teacher. One of the things I like the most about Japan is, I guess it's just the people. They're, for the most part, they are very, very polite, very respectful to you. And also, it's very clean and it's easy to get around, a lot of stuff. But those are two things I liked. What do I like the least about Japan? One is the trash system when you have to dump things. I hate that because there's a million rules on how to dump your garbage. Also, bureaucracy. You have to ask 6 different people to get one thing done. And that's something that really annoys me. Compared to other places, people are not staring at you as much. People are respectful. More respectful than other places, and it's a nice change compared to where I was before. I was in Shanghai for 2.5 years, and in Shanghai it's different. When you walk down the street, people will look and stare and whisper and point and still stare at you some more and tug at their friends to tell their friends to look and point and stare. So it's coming to Japan. It's a breeze. It's easy. It's given me different perspective on different people, because now when I come into a situation, I don't just say, oh, they're Asian, they're this. That's not the case. Surprisingly, Asians are very, very different. They're very, very diverse. So don't assume that because you met a Chinese person from Xi'an, you know all Chinese people. And don't assume that you met a Korean person from Busan, you know all Korean people. You know, it's, their people are diverse, people are very different, but also people are very much the same. A lot of people just have the same goals in life, to be happy, to get married, to hopefully raise kids, and they're just trying to survive life. And you realize that even though there are a lot of differences, a lot of things are very much the same in everywhere you go in the world. One of the things is with working in those three different countries, the work life is a little bit different. First in Korea, South Korea, the work life for the most part is pretty relaxed, kind of. But the only thing is, a lot of times they throw you a lot of curveballs. So they'll be like, oh, we need you to do this yesterday, or we need you to mark these papers for tomorrow. And there's like 50 papers. So a lot of times you'll get a lot of random curveballs that you have to adjust to right away. That's one thing I like about in Japan is just the work structure is just everything set up where it's like, okay, we're doing this, 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 and this. And you know that way ahead of time. And it's easier to plan ahead of time to complete your work. In Shanghai, it was a lot of the same thing too. People were expecting you to do certain things, but they wouldn't really give you enough time. And it's like, okay, we need these papers to be marked, and you have 3 days. There's about 150 essays. Good luck. We want these in 3 days. So those things I don't miss, and I do like about Japan is just organization when it comes to work. People are less likely to surprise you with random stuff to do. So I really, really like that. The kids I find in South Korea, they might be a little bit louder. They want to be more active, but you can push them. You can push them more. Like, you can push them to do more work than in many other countries. And in in Shanghai, it's similar to that, where you have to guide them more, but you can also still push them and they will still, most of them will still get it done. In Japan, it's not encouraged, people don't encourage you to push the kids academically as much as the other countries would. There are a few cases where parents will say, I want you to push my kid, I want you to test my kid more. But for the most part, people here, especially when it comes to English and English education, as a foreign teacher, they don't want you to push their kids or to try to get their kids to learn as much as the other countries do. So that's one big difference, is just the volume of work that the kids will have to do is a little bit less when it comes to English education here. Best compensation is going to be China, without a doubt. But that comes with a lot of other things that you have to worry about. So in China right now, for like ESL teaching, China, best place to go for getting money. But if you like Instagram, if you like Facebook, if you like YouTube, if you like pretty much any Western social media, you can't use it in China unless you have a VPN. If you want to be more politically expressive, no, you can't do that. If you want to share your opinions about stuff openly, you can't do that. If you want to be like move around freely, and if you want to like stay wherever you want to stay in China, you can't do that. So granted, you can get paid a lot more money, but there are things that comes with that. So just be aware. I wouldn't say don't go to China. China is a great place. I really like China, and great history, great place to travel to. But there are things that you have to be aware of. It's still a communist country. So don't think you're gonna go there and be all free and just walk around anywhere you want. It's still communist. Don't try to assume that you know what people are thinking and doing, and don't assume that they're gonna be against you. Sometimes in differences of a culture, it might come off as being, someone might come off as being rude, or come off as being not understanding, or come off as being racist or against you. Many times that's not the case. You have to listen to what they're saying, look at the situation, and try to understand the culture. Once you do those three things, then you can understand what their point is. So don't automatically assume that someone is against you, or someone is being racist, or someone is trying to harm you or do bad things against you. Just look, assess, and then react. Especially with black people, I encourage you to explore, get jobs overseas, try to meet new people, and not just people who are like you or who understands you. Just try to meet new people who are very different from you. And then with that, you can understand them and get a better understanding of yourself. And just try new things, not only with when it comes to just like things like food or places to stay, but like go to a different country, go to a different place, go to like try a new concert or try a new type of music that you've never listened to before. Just expand your experience, expand your horizon, and you'll be pleasantly surprised. And what people might say when they say that, they might say like, you know, I don't have money to travel, but there are different ways that you can travel. Like myself, I teach overseas, so you can travel by teaching, you can travel by doing cruises, you can travel by doing different things. So try to find opportunities to broaden your horizon and broaden your experience with people. Don't be afraid to try new things, and don't be afraid to be yourself. Even though sometimes you might not, it might go against the image that people think of you, don't worry about it. Be yourself, try new things, and try to be true to yourself amongst everything else. People can find me online on, I guess, Facebook, Robert Levy, L-E-V-Y.
Thank you so much for watching. If you'd like to see weekly videos about the Black experience in Japan, feel free to subscribe to this channel. If you know someone that would like to be featured, or if you yourself would like to be featured, send us a message on our Facebook page at The Black Experience Japan, or send us a tweet on Twitter at TheBlackXJP. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next time. Bye for now.